Puppeteer and Selenium are two well-known open source tools mainly used for browser automation and testing. Released only 5 years ago, Puppeteer has gained appreciation from developers thanks to its useful features and exceptional performance. And while Selenium is a more mature framework dating back to 2004, it still remains to be an industry leader for web automation, supporting multiple programming languages and platforms. I'm Lisa, and today let's compare these two frameworks so that you can make a concrete decision on which fits your needs best. Puppeteer is a Node.js library mostly used for creating an automated testing environment. It was developed by Google with the idea of providing a high-level API to control Chrome and Chromium over the DevTools protocol. Unlike Selenium, which supports various programming languages, Puppeteer doesn't aim to provide a broad experience for developers. It focuses on offering a specific set of control structures, supporting solely JavaScript and serving as a remote control library for Chrome. Developers largely use Puppeteer for such tasks as testing Chrome extensions, taking screenshots and generating PDFs of pages for UI testing, performing tests on the latest versions of Chromium, automating a range of manual testing processes such as form submissions, keyboard inputs, etc., web scraping. By the way, if you'd like to see a detailed tutorial on how to perform web scraping with Puppeteer, check out our extensive blog post linked in the video description. In comparison to Puppeteer, Selenium is a testing library that supports not only Chrome and Chromium, but also Firefox, Safari, Opera, Microsoft Edge. Additionally, Selenium scripts can be written using JavaScript, Ruby, C#, Java, and Python. All this enables developers to perform sophisticated tests in their preferred languages, as well as target different browsers by using one single tool. Another thing that should be mentioned about Selenium is the presence of such components as Selenium WebDriver, Selenium IDE, and Selenium Grid, which further extend the capabilities of this library and allow users to satisfy different testing needs. The common Selenium use cases include web performance testing, web application testing, automation testing, performance testing, data scraping. Check out our in-depth Selenium tutorial to learn how to perform web scraping with it using Python. As usual, the link is in the description. To find out which tool is a better choice for your specific activities, carefully weighting all the benefits and drawbacks of each is an essential step. Let's start with the ones for Puppeteer. Advantages include access to the DevTools protocol and the ability to control one of the world's most popular browsers, Chrome. One browser, one language. While this one definitely sounds like a disadvantage, it's exactly what helps Puppeteer to run extremely fast, especially when compared to Selenium. Less dependency requirements, as there is no separate maintenance of browser drivers. Availability of various useful performance management features, such as taking screenshots and recording load performance. As for the disadvantages, supports only one programming language, JavaScript. Currently supports only the Chrome browser. Moving on to Selenium, advantages include seeks to support a wide variety of browsers, platforms, and programming languages. Inbuilt tools, WebDriver, IDE, and Grid, which allow for the development of a comprehensive testing and automation framework. Direct integrations with CI/CD, which are continuous integration and continuous delivery deployment, ensuring increased capabilities. As for the disadvantages, Selenium has a more complicated installation process due to its support of various platforms, languages, and browsers. Unlike Puppeteer, fails to provide different performance management capabilities. Has a steep learning curve. Now, let's compare these two tools based on fundamental differences in setting up the environment and web scraping efficiency using Node.js. Both Puppeteer and Selenium installation processes are simple. The main distinction is the prerequisite libraries. While Puppeteer users merely need to install it using a simple npm command, Selenium users must follow language-specific instructions. Moving on to browser control, both tools allow programmatic web browser control. You can use this ability to scrape dynamic content from your target web page. Let's see key code differences to launch a Chrome headless instance, navigate to a specific web page, wait for specific dynamic content to load, and scrape the page. Our target for scraping will be coastestrape.com. This is a dynamic web page where all the quotes are loaded dynamically through the relevant JavaScript file. The JavaScript file renders quotes in div elements, all having a quote class. Selenium supports multiple browsers, so it requires importing specific browser drivers, Chrome drivers in our case, along with the web driver. Chrome driver is implicit with Puppeteer. Puppeteer uses an available launch method to launch the browser instance, and the new page method creates a new browser tab. Now, the go-to method can navigate the tab to any given URL. Selenium, on the other hand, uses builder constructor to build a new builder instance followed by specific options. The build method at the end creates and returns a new instance of the web driver session. Please note that you must enclose available calls inside an asynchronous function. Let's see the differences between Puppeteer and Selenium in waiting for specific JavaScript content to load. The following code waits for JavaScript to load a div element with the quote class. Puppeteer uses the waitForSelector method, while Selenium uses the wait method in conjunction with until property to wait for a specific element to load. Puppeteer uses querySelectorAll method to select and return a list of all the matching elements specified by given CSS selectors. On the other hand, Selenium provides a findElements method to extract the relevant elements matching the byselectors. Notice the evaluate method in the Puppeteer code. It allows executing a function in the current tab or page context. This means that you can access and manipulate the elements in the document object model of the current tab, and then return a value as a result, which is the quote string in our case. Puppeteer offers the close method to close the browser instance, while Selenium provides the quit method to exit the browser instance and destroy the driver session. At this point, it's already clear that both Puppeteer and Selenium are two powerful tools with exceptional capabilities for testing automation. However, while they do have several differences, the final decision of whether you should use one or the other will depend on your or your organization's specific needs. If you work exclusively with Chrome, Puppeteer is the go-to choice. Its high-level API will provide you with unparalleled control over the browser, and the excellent speed and focus offered by it will make sure you achieve efficiency in setting up tests. What's more, considering the fact that Puppeteer is more of web automation than testing library, it'll be more suitable for such activities as web crawling and scraping. On the other hand, in case you need to support other browsers and programming languages, you should definitely choose Selenium. With Selenium WebDriver offering cross-browser support, you'll be able to interact with any browser directly, significantly extending the test scope without the need to rely on any external tools. Found this video useful? Don't hesitate to leave a comment below and subscribe to our channel. If you have any questions about this or any other scraping-related topic, we're always ready to talk via email. Thanks for tuning in and see you soon!